A very good morning to all the learners. Good morning. Okay, so today it is 18 September Saturday. We are going to look at some of the histology topics. Okay, so since it is a marathon YT session, we are going to have lots and lots of classes. Please do watch the classes. This is going to be histology, and I will also be having a class at 9 p.m. this evening, okay? 9 p.m. is going to be on general anatomy. It's going to be really important and very, very informative. So I just not only include the general anatomy topic, but also I try to include the clinical aspects of many things. So in general anatomy, we usually don't, include the clinical aspects. For example, yesterday was the skeletal system. So I included the other deformities like the cleidocranial dystosis, and I also included the achondroplasia. So all this will be included, even though it is a general anatomy class. So do watch my classes. And now we have histology. Okay. So let me just quickly see if everyone is able to listen to what I'm talking and also able to see the video clearly. Okay. So, okay, hope I'm audible. So if anyone is right now watching, let me just check. Please do hit a like so that I know that you are all watching and you're able to connect with me. So I'm Dr. Rohini, and this is my credential. I'm MD from KMC Mangalore, that is located in Karnataka. And I also have PhD from Savita University, Chennai. This is Tamil Nadu degree. Okay, so Chennai Savita University is also one of the finest universities. So if you happen to get a seat at Savita University, that's also a good bargain, actually. So of course, the KMC is the best because you know that it is deemed university, and also the curriculum is very nice and very organized. Especially all these coastal regions have got very nice colleges. So this is deemed university. And it is really, really nice. And all those ranks that you must have already observed from 10th standard, all the board exams, most of the ranks go to the coastal area. Because that's one of the reasons I'm saying that coastal area colleges are really nice, well-organized, curriculum is very nice. So is the KMC, Mangalore and Manipal. Okay, that is Kasturba Medical College. Okay, I also have a medical transcription and MBA in hospital administration, that is from USA. So if there is anybody who is an aspirant to go abroad or want to take up exams, that is abroad, you can definitely approach me to ask for the same. You can also take guidance from the Unacademy experts. And here is my Telegram group, Anatomy by Dr. Rohini. So join this, and also you can join with many, many more educators by joining Let's Crack Neat PG Telegram group. Okay, so that is something I really wanted to bring it down. And let's see if there is anybody who has any questions. Okay, so if you can ping your name, I can even read out your name and know who is watching. All right, so let's talk about the topic. So now here we have the topic. Gross anatomy, and subtopic is histology. And here I'm going to tell you what exactly you need to know in a particular slide to identify the slide. So there are various slides. There are slides in, systemic slides are there, and there are so many slides, which are general slides. So we'll talk about general as well as some of the systemic slides. Now here we have the first one. What is this one? How does it look like? So now here you can see in this particular one, you can see there is a lumen, right? You can see the lumen, and it is not continuous. It is not continuous, and it's also irregular. So this will be of a vein, okay? So it has the three layers. You can see the vein has the three layers. You have tunica. Let me just quickly take a different color. Okay. So we have in the vein, we have tunica, topmost one is adventitia, that is outermost one. I can say adventitia, tunica media, and tunica intima. Intima is the innermost one. The innermost one which is facing the lumen is intima. All right. So the intima is lined by endothelium. Tunica media, of course, is the muscle layer that you can see here. And then adventitia is the outermost one that you can see there, that is made up of collagen fibers. Now, actually, this is not our focal point. We are supposed to look at other things around it. What is around it? You can see that there is something like a break and there are vacuole looking structures like this. What are these? They're all lined by simple squamous cells. They're all lined by simple squamous cells. That means you don't see many layers. It is just one single layer. And these cells are one single layer thick. Why it is? Because you need these cells for exchange of materials. Any exchange, you know, has to happen between the thinnest layer. So on the capillary side also, you should have the thin layer. And on the alveoli side also, you should have thin layer. Since the simple squamous is lining them, these cells are called mesothelium here. It is nothing but the simple squamous cells. And this is also simple squamous, and that is called endothelium in case of vessels. Now, the exchange of material takes place. What exchange? It is the gas, oxygen and carbon dioxide. Okay, so that's what takes place here. And you can see all these are nothing but alveoli part of the lung. So that's how you can identify the alveoli of lung. There are so many breaks in between and there are gaps in between, and it is not filled with any material because it is filled with air. So you can see there is no colloidal material, no connective tissue in between them. Only thing that you can see is simple epithelium, that is squamous epithelium, covering a vacuole, that is alveoli of lung. All right, so that is alveoli of lung. All right, let's go to the next one. The next one here, what can you identify? So if you zoom this even more, if you can zoom this even more, you should be able to see some follicles. Okay, you can see some follicles like this. These follicles are lined by cells. Anything that is follicle, it could be ovarian follicle, it could be the thyroid follicle, any endocrine gland that has acini follicle. Remember, acini or follicle, it is secreting, right? It secretes. So anything that secretes is always lined by cuboidal epithelium. So you have to remember this is lined by cuboidal because it is secretory in function. So now you can see all this, something that looks like mosaic appearance. Mosaic appearance you can see here. And that is the feature of the thyroid follicles. The thyroid follicle is the example here. And for what? You have cuboidal epithelium. You can see the cuboidal epithelium and you can see so many follicles. If you just look at one of the follicles, this is one of the follicles which is lined by the thyroid, which is lined by the cuboidal epithelium, and inside you will have the colloid material. So there is colloid material seen, and also thyroid can take up the squamous flat appearance, it can take up cuboidal appearance. And also when it is, you know, different stages of activity, hyperactive, underactive or normal activity, it can have different shape of the cells. But when it is secreting, it will have the cuboidal appearance. That's why we call this follicles as having cuboidal epithelium. Okay, so that is very important. And you can also see a lot of connective tissue, and in between you should be able to see some parafollicular cells. They are called C cells there. Parafollicular cells are C cells and they secrete calcitonin. Okay, so that is about the thyroid. All right, let's go to the next one and see what we have in the next one. What do you see here? You can see there are some, you know, elevations like this. There is folds. Actually, you can call them as folds. A lot of folds are there. And these foldings of the inner lumen, this particular structure has lumen and there are foldings, okay? And it is all lined by cells. What cells are these? Look at this size of the cell. It is tall cells. Okay, these are tall cells. And you see that these are 10x magnification. If you have a magnification of 40x, you'll be able to see the individual cells. But in this one particular, you can only identify the type of, you know, epithelium. This is something that looks like gallbladder, okay? Gallbladder, because there is lumen and you can see that the inside of the gallbladder is thrown into these foldings and these are the cells that is lining these foldings. And this is nothing but the simple columnar cells, okay? Simple columnar cells. Simple columnar cells are present in those places where there is need for only storage or protection. So you must remember what is its actual need or function. Storage and protection is done by simple columnar, you know, type of epithelium. And that example you can keep as the gallbladder. So that is gallbladder. And you can see all those foldings you can see. And you can see the lining epithelium. Also, you can see gallbladder is just a storage organ. There is no digestion taking place there. There is no secretion. And you also know that cystic duct arises from there. And that joins with the hepatic duct. And that forms the common bile duct. And this would join with the pancreatic duct and enter into the second part of duodenum. So you know all this, right? So this one is gallbladder, all right? So we call it simple. Why we call it simple? Because it is single layer. If it was many layer, we would call it as stratified. It is single layer. That's why the name simple. Okay. So wherever you see simple columnar, simple cuboidal, there are three types of epithelium. Cuboidal, columnar, and squamous. Okay. The shape of the squamous looks like this, like fish. And the centrally placed nuclei is like this. The cuboidal ones will look same height and breadth. And centrally placed nuclei. And you can see the columnar ones are the tall ones like this. And they have oval nuclei, which are very close to the basement membrane. Okay. In columnar, there are so many modifications. Only in columnar, you can see modifications. Like it can have in between goblet cells could be present. These are goblet cells. Or it could also be pseudo. It could also be pseudo. I'll tell you what is pseudo in the next coming slides. Okay, so here we have Satnika. I like your name, Satnika. So nice. It is Satnika Chatterjee saying good morning. And we have Murli, of course, always. Abhishek, good morning. Abhishek, you were also there in my class previous. Nice. And yeah. And we also have Shiv Bahadur Chaudhary, nice to see you. For absorption purposes, no villi. Which one will observe? In this particular one, no villi. But if it is in some other place, of course, there will be villi. That would be present in the cuboidal ones. Sorry, yeah, cuboidal ones. All right. So columnar will have cilia, not the villi. So I'll tell you what will have which one. Cuboidal will have villi. The columnar will have cilia. Okay. All right. Next one. So here what you can see is many things that are thrown into folds. Can you see? There is a lumen that is not, you know, rounded or oval. It looks as if it is some star shape. Do you see the star in the center? I'll just put that outline. Do you see that star? Okay, it has a star-shaped lumen. And the star usually has five corners. This one looks like it has many corners. So all the, you know, epithelium of the urinary system has a customized epithelium. What is that called? It is called transitional epithelium. So transitional name itself will tell you trans. So that means that what does that mean? The transitional epithelium tells you this is not appendix. Where do you see the, you don't see any lymphatic nodules. You don't see. Okay, this is the urinary bladder. Okay, ureter, urinary bladder. All right, in this particular one, it is little difficult to make out. This looks like urinary bladder because it has more folds. Yes, ureter will have a typical star-shaped, but this has little more, you know, folding. So it is either ureter or urinary bladder. So some of the slides are little tricky. So, but you have to identify the epithelium. So we are identifying the epithelium as transitional epithelium. There is no lymphatic nodule. So remember that. Appendix will have lot of lymphatic aggregations. Here it is not there. So that is not appendix. No. So in one upper right corner, yes, that is not lymphatic. Yeah, you're talking about this one. That is not. Okay. So that is not. So this is transitional epithelium, and transitional epithelium will have a basement membrane on which sits the columnar or cuboidal. It will not be squamous. It's always either columnar or cuboidal epithelium. And then you will have many layers of stratified epithelium. And then for about 4 to 5 layers of squamous cells sitting on each other like this. And then the topmost layer will have umbrella shaped cells. Okay. They're more, even more flattened out. So they may also have binucleated cells. Binucleated. That is the thing to remember. But all that you can see when you focus above 40x, you can see. But in this one, everything is 10x. So you cannot make out those details. You cannot make out. Yes. Okay. Shiv, in the one, something different, ma'am. What is that? Intrigue. What is trig? You mean transitional epithelium you're talking about? Okay, you type, I'll come back to that. So this is the transitional epithelium. You can see the umbrella shaped cells. By looking at this, you should be trigone. You mean trigone? In trigone, urinary bladder. I'll tell you a nice trick to remember the urinary bladder. See, this is the urinary bladder. I hope you all can see my hand. This is the urinary bladder. And you can see that it has the surfaces. It has the surface. This is the superior surface. And these two are the lateral surface. And you have an apex pointed upwards like this. That is held by median umbilical ligament. And then you have the two ureter openings on the back. Okay, ureter openings on the back. And then you have the urethra opening at the bottom. And this will continue down as the neck of the urinary bladder. Okay, apex, base, superior surface to lateral surface. And then you have three openings, two ureter openings and one urethra. If you just, you know, complete that triangle by joining these three points, you will get a region which is very smooth inflowing. So it has the part which has the inflow part is very smooth. Okay. So this part has got all the urine. You know that urinary bladder has got all those layers, right? One of the layer is absent here. What is that layer that is absent? That's what makes it very, very smooth. It does not have submucosa. It has no submucosa. No submucosa. That is the reason it is very, very smooth. Okay, so you please remember, trigone part of urinary bladder has no submucosa. That is why it is held tight. And it directs the flow of urine to urethra. Okay. Next one. I hope I made it clear. Next one. What do you see here? What do you see? We see some cells scattered. You see it scattered? Shiv, what do you think? Is it scattered? Do you see it scattered? I see it scattered. And I can also see that these cells have got a lot of fibers between them. I see a lot of elastic fibers between them. And I also see that these cells are chondrocytes. So tell me what this is, chondrocytes. And it has taken up the stain pink, eosin. What do you think it is? Let's see how many of you will know what it is. What do you think this is? It has taken up the stain pink. It looks more pink in color. It is not blue. So what do you think it is? Anyone who has a better understanding in histology? It cannot be hyaline cartilage. I said hyalo means what? Hyalo means blue. Is it blue? Is it blue? I'm saying it is pink. You can see that it is pink. So what do you think it is? What is the other cartilage we have? Hyaline is blue. Elastic is pink. Takes eosin. Remember E for elastic. And then we have white fibro. It is again almost off-white because of the collagen fibers. High amount of collagen fibers. Yeah. So this is elastic cartilage. Now here you can see the cells are all scattered. That's one feature. The cells are all scattered. Okay. Next, what else you see? You can see the fibers. They're all loaded with fibers. That is elastic fibers you can see. So elastic fibers, you can see, do you see the perichondrium? This region is the perichondrium region. So you can see some smaller cells here. Smaller cells are the baby cells, which actually are the perichondrium. Okay, perichondrium later becomes periosteum of the bone. Perichondrium. Perichondrium is present only in case of hyaline cartilage and elastic cartilage. White fibro does not have. Eosin will stain it red pink. Yes. Okay. Eosin will stain it. Blue stain is hematoxylin. Hematoxylin is blue. This one you tell me. Now Murli can say easily that it is hyaline. So what color it is? It is hyalo, blue color. Why do we call this hyaline cartilage? Because the fibers aren't seen. Do you see any fibers? We cannot make out fibers. Why? Because of the refractive index. Refractive index of the matrix and the fibers both are same. That's why. Because the matrix and the fibers that are embedded in the matrix, they both have the same refractive index, about 1.5, okay, 5.7 or something. So what happens here is that the same as the refractive index of glass, it looks glossy or translucent. And also look at the group of cells. Can you see some of the cells are in groups? What are these called? Anybody has an idea? Some of them are in groups. See, so many are in groups. What do you understand by these? They are in groups. When they are in groups, you call them as cell nest. Cell nest. A cell nest is groups. Okay, so we have, So these are cell nests. That is not seen in elastic cartilage or white fibrocartilage. Elastic, you should remember, it is scattered. Chondrocytes and hyaline, it is cell nest or groups. And in case of white fibrocartilage, you can see that they are placed in a row. Okay, so this is very, very important. Very important to remember this. Next, you can see some very off-white. Hardly you can make out off-white. What is this? It is very, very off-white. What is this? You hardly can make out what it is. What do you think this is? And it also has those circles that go round and round. What are these? It is not white fibro. Just because we saw the hyaline cartilage and we saw the elastic cartilage, the third one need not be a white fibrocartilage. It can be simply completely different slide. What is it? It's not a cartilage slide at all. It is a different slide. It is not a cartilage slide. Think out of the box. What else it is? So what else doesn't take up the stain? The white fibro, because of collagen fibers, will not take up the good staining. What about bone? Does it take up? What about nervous tissue? Even that will not take up stain. So you remember nervous tissue, bone, white fibro cartilage will not take stain. Not take stain. Okay, here you can see all this, and this is nothing but the concentric lamellae. Now you tell me what is this. Concentric lamellae is there. Now you tell me what it is. What is it? Is it a nervous tissue? Is it bone? Or white fibrocartilage? What is it? I'm giving you three options. Tell me what it is. It is the transverse section of bone. Transverse section of bone, where you can see the concentric lamellae. There is no H&E staining. H&E staining is not there. And you can see that it is very dull, off-white in color, right? And you can also see concentric lamellae. And if you have gone to the edge, you can also see these are nothing but interstitial lamellae. There is interstitial lamellae and concentric lamellae. So remember these two. All right, varies. Okay, so this is the concentric and interstitial. Remember, this is under 10x. So you will not be able to see much detail with whatever information available. You should be able to guess. So you will not get something that looks like how it looks in the books. Okay, it definitely looks much different from a nice, you know, diagram drawn by an artist. It doesn't look exactly like that. So you have to learn to identify just with few, you know, points. So here we have next one. that is concentric lamellae and interstitial lamellae. And this has got in the center, it has a canal called Haversian canal. And around that, whatever you see, those lamellae that is laid exactly tell you how old the bone is. Okay, the outermost part of this bone will be lined by the perichondrium. Okay, it is lined by the perichondrium. So now here you have the osteocytes which are trapped between this calcified bone material. And this each one osteocytes, if you look out, it will have a cell like this and it will be present within the lacunae. So that is the lacunae and inside is the cell osteocytes. And these are the cytoplasmic extensions coming from the cell. So you have to show it coming from the cell, not from the lacunae. Okay, those are the cytoplasmic extensions and that is called canaliculi. This is the structure of a osteocyte. What do you mean by site? It is a cell. And osteocytes are actually the oldest cells. These are the ones which are trapped and they were before becoming osteocytes or turning into or differentiating into osteocytes. They were called the osteoblast. So it was osteoblast first and then once they are done with their activity of bone building, they no longer continue to be osteoblast and they either become the lining cells or they undergo apoptosis or they become osteocytes. Okay, so they turn into osteocyte. Let's look at this one. What do you think this is? So in this particular one, you can see some cells that are trapped. Okay, there are some cells that are trapped. Now you have to tell me what this one is. There are a lot of collagen fibers. And there are some cells which are trapped here and there. I can see some chondrocytes that are present. They're also trapped. What are these? They're present in row actually. So you have to remember it is white fibrocartilage. White fibrocartilage. It is not bone tissue. See, it is not straight. You don't have those lines straight. It is there. The collagen fibers, you can see them in bundles. You can see them in bundles and they are wavy like this. Okay. Can see them. These are collagen bundles. They are wavy. That's why they look like this. And there is no branching. But they resemble the LS of bone so much. They resemble the LS of bone. But this one particularly is white cartilage. Okay. So now here you can see those cells are embedded between those collagen bundles and this is how they look. They are white fibrocartilage. So it is white fibrocartilage. Example you can give is intervertebral disc and also in the pubic symphysis. Next, this one, you can identify this one as the a blue color part. So now here, what is this one? This is blue. Okay. Let me just change the color of the pen. I myself, I'm not able to. What is this one? It is blue in color. If you go closely and see what it looks like. Yes. It is blue in color and it is hyaline cartilage. Okay. But here we are looking at something else. What is this one? What is that? What is that? And that looks like epithelium, right? It looks like epithelium. What epithelium is that? What epithelium is that? That epithelium is pseudo stratified, ciliated, columnar, epithelium. Okay, pseudo stratified, ciliated, columnar epithelium. That means it has a false, you know, assumption that it is stratified, and it is definitely ciliated and columnar, but the stratification is false. So it is on the basement membrane, and all these, yes, it is trachea. It is trachea. You're right. You can see that these cells are on the basement membrane and they are tall cells, and the nuclei is present at various heights. Okay, so it looks as if there are many cells, and this is the cilia. So this is how this part looks like. It is pseudo-stratified ciliated epithelium, which is also called respiratory epithelium. Respiratory epithelium, pseudo-stratified ciliated epithelium, and this is present only in the respiratory system. Okay, you have nasal cavity, same epithelium, and then you have the trachea, same epithelium. But when it comes to the bronchi, it is a lumen with a duct. So it will definitely have secretion, and the epithelium definitely would change. So this is the respiratory epithelium for you. The example is trachea. All right. Let's go to the next one and see. Now here you have to identify. See, this is the lumen, and you can also see the rough edged surface, and you can remember this is one of the bronchi, and you can also see there are a lot of gaps and vacuoles. What is that of? It is nothing but the alveoli of lung. Okay, from a different angle. That is alveoli of lung from a different angle. Next, what else we have? Let's see this. What do you think this is? Now, you can see so many osteocytes. Now, I'm giving you a hint. So many osteocytes I can see, but the cut section is like this. It is not transverse. It is like this. And in between that, you can also see there are some connections. Now, here you can see some connections. What these connections are, yes, but the section of the bone is LS, okay, longitudinal section, and those connections between one osteon to the other osteon is the Wolfman's canal. Okay, that's Wolfman's canal. All right, now here you tell me, what does this one look like? What does this one look like? How does this look like? How do you identify this? So something that is again thrown into folds. You can see that there are folds. Let's see how many of you can identify this. There is folds. There are What do you think this is? Anybody? So you can see the mucosa is thrown into folds. So you can see mucosa. Anyone writing? And in the mucosa, what do you see? You can see the gastric glands. And what else you see? That's the first one. And you can also see submucosa. Correct? That is this portion, submucosa. And this is the first one, which is mucosa, which is thrown into folds. And the lower portion, here it is not seen, that is muscularis mucosa. Muscular layer, which will have a circular and longitudinal muscle layer. Okay, so that is what you can see. All right, so mucosa, submucosa, and you can see the outermost of all these layers is serosa. Serosa. So out of this 1, 2, 3, and 4, you can see the prominent layer will be the third one and the first one, mucosa. Because mucosa is thrown into folds and you can see so many gastric glands. I told you this is 10x. If you have been watching the same on the 40x, you should be able to identify those chief cells and parietal cells, etc. So please don't get confused. This is small, you know, foldings like this. And that is the stomach slide. Okay. If it is tall ones, then it would be the gallbladder. People do get confused with gallbladder and stomach, but the gallbladder has got tall foldings because the size is small. And inside the stomach, these rugae are short foldings. And you can see that the foldings are really shorter. It is not of much height. This is shorter. Okay, this is shorter and this length is shorter. So foldings are very short. And that's what gives you a hint that it is stomach and not gallbladder. So next one here, we are getting some slides which are from a different angle. Now you have to tell me what this one is. How many of you can identify this? Let's see how many of you have identified this. What is this according to you? Murli, what do you think it is? Why do you think it is fallopian tube? Oh, you are talking about the previous one. Fallopian tube will have cilia. There was no cilia there. Was there any cilia? No. This is no. Please see properly. Do you see the mosaic appearance here? See, they're all actually follicles. You have to really have a very good eye. So all this mosaic appearance, what do you think it is? It is not spread out. These are all follicles. Do you also see some blue dots? If it was skeletal muscle, it wouldn't have been like that. So many blue nuclei wouldn't have been there. It is not multinucleated skeletal muscle, right? So here this blue dot is from the follicle. From the cells, these blue dots are. So this one is thyroid again, okay? Thyroid follicle. See, from a different angle, if I show you the same slide, you are getting confused. So this is thyroid follicle. Please now see again closely. You can see the follicles. You can see the blue ones. That is the nuclei. And you can also see the cell. And the inside, the pink is nothing but the colloid material. Okay. Let's go to the next one. Now you can tell me. Whatever you guessed just now, you can tell me. This is skeletal muscle. TS. Transverse section of the skeletal muscle, where you can see the skeletal muscles are, you know, divided by the fascia. You can see the fascia between them, and you can see skeletal muscle is wrapped in perineurium, epineurium, endomysium. Perimysium, epimysium, and endomysium, not neurium, mysium. So that is, neurium is for the nerve fibers. This is for the muscle. So it is mycium. So you can also see the deep fascia dividing those muscle groups, you can see. And this is definitely a TS. It is not a LS of the skeletal muscle. Okay. So that is it for today's class. We are going to have many, many more, you know, slides in the part two. So we are going to have another session with the part two, where you are going to see some more, you know, topics or some more slides you are going to watch from histo slides. These are all histo slides. And at this, I would like to end, and I would like to thank all those who are participating and giving out those answers and making this a nice session. And here is some of the credentials that I just, you know, mentioned it the first two slides, and here is the plus subscription. So what is so special about plus subscription? You can access both the live and the recorded classes in the plus subscription, and you can also study anywhere on the device. So now here it could be the mobile phones, or it could be your laptop, or it could be your pen tab, any one you can use for access. You need not be confined to just one thing. And you also have question bank access, and you can also go with the subscriptions, 12-month subscription. You will definitely get printed notes as well. So many people are used to, you know, using the printed notes. So these people can definitely go with the 12-month subscription, because you will get everything in the form of hard copy, and that is what you want, you'll get it. So this is one thing about press subscriptions. And you also have iconic subscription, where you have access to Unacademy as well as the prep ladder. So it is like a bonus, two things you can access with one account. All right, so this is really interesting, because prep ladder also has a lot of curriculum that also you can get. And definitely, if you have more time to study, this is what you should be doing, actually. Iconic subscription, because you get more material, more the things, it's better always. There is special class features. What is so special about this? My classes are mostly on Wednesdays, and these Wednesdays are the special classes, and I have my classes starting as early as 7:30 in the morning, just like we did today. And all these classes are very interactive. Polls are there for learners, and raise a hand feature. You'll never miss a class because you get notified. And then you can also see the lecture classes. You know, at the end, you can download the PDF notes, and anytime, anywhere, you can access them. So this is one thing special about all the special classes. And one more thing I would like to, you know, request all of you is, just check out our YouTube classes. The continuity of these YouTube classes will most probably be on the special classes, because if we have the topics taken on YouTube, you will definitely find all those MCQs related to that in the special classes. So for that to happen, you need to have an app that is called Unacademy Learners app. So please download that Unacademy Learners app, and then you can use the code ROHINI10. So this is a must. You can use the code, and this is called the unlock code, referral code. You can also use this code to refer to your friends for subscription. If you have subscribed and you want to refer to your friends, you can use the code, and you can also get 10% discount when you do the subscription. So you want to go for subscription and you don't know what is the code. This is the code. Please use the code, get the subscriptions, and because subscriptions are always nice, because you'll get the entire curriculum covered. So here are the 25,000 high yield clinical questions from the QBank series, and everything is actually limited time offer, because you have to hurry up. Exams are coming here, and then 12-month subscription, you can, you know, get it just for 38 to 50. You have a discount of about 10% with my code. So please use this code whenever you want to go for subscription without fail. So this is the regular price and final price. So look at the price slash. So use the code ROHINI10 to get limited time offer. First 500 students only will get this. So all this is for you to note down. So the code has to be noted down so that you don't make any mistakes in entering the code. The code has no space in between. So make sure the code is written properly. So these are some of our proud star learners. We have many, many more, and they're not listed here. Not everyone is listed. These are the FMG, June 2021 scores. We have so many students who have bagged very close to the 300 marks. And we also have Target Next 2022 batch running and Focus FMG. All these are really, really going to, you know, keep you on your toes and make you reach the goal. So just go and get more information of all these, you know, batches that are running. You will get PDF notes for the sessions. You will have all fast-paced educators teaching you. So you'll be thoroughly trained in your subjects. And these are some clinical examinations and procedures batch. So we have very innovative curriculum. So you should, you know, just take a demo and just try it out. This is Boost Your Medical PG with 24 month subscription, you can get 4 months free. So almost, almost 2 years and above subscription is for you. And here 12 plus 2 months is free again. So you get a lot of freebies whenever you have been using the code. So use the code for all the free stuff as well as subscribed ones. And here you have a option of going for EMI. Okay, so you have no cost EMI option with the minimum 6 month subscription. When you do so, you have to go with the code again. So use the code for all the free stuff to access for all the tests, quiz, wherever you are prompted to use the code. Do remember this code. Use the code and also go for the subscription for 10% discount. So with all these, I would like to thank everyone and those here. Okay. Interacting with me, kindly hit a like. If you have liked the session, do hit a like. Follow me on my profile. You can also look out for my profile using this username RoAqua, or you can also see under this name, I teach NEET PG students, I teach anatomy, and I'm Dr. Rohini Avdani. And don't forget to join the Telegram group, Anatomy by Dr. Rohini. So this is definitely going to keep you more motivated, because we do interact with a lot of clinical pictures, and anything that you don't understand from the class, you can definitely post a question there. And also we do a lot of daily MCQs. So all that you can do, and also you can join Let's Crack NEET PG Telegram channel. All this is going to keep you very motivated. So do join that, and see you all again at 9 p.m. with more session. Thank you. You all have it.